Hello everyone, welcome to the Digital Skilling Preparation course. The look and feel of your document changes when you do some formatting in your document. Yes, today we are going to discuss the various formatting options available in the Google document. Formatting your document means changing the font size, adding color, adding bullet points and other similar features to make the document more presentable. Let's see the detailed process of formatting a document in this video. Let's take this document for example. Formatting the text in this document would make it much easier to read. I'd like to start by selecting all the text and making the font bigger by just clicking the font size button on the toolbar and then choose a higher number, or you can click on this plus or minus sign to change the font size. To change the font type, click the font button here. As you can see, the default option shows Arial. Scroll down and find any font type you like. You can also click More Fonts option, where a window will open and there will be many fonts to choose from. And click OK. You can highlight a text to make it stand out. I'm selecting this line and selecting this pen icon to add highlight to the text. Another way to make your text stand out is to use bold, italic, or underline options. These can be found on the toolbar. You can also change the color of the text by clicking this text color option and selecting a color of your choice. Spacing is an important formatting feature in a document. Paragraph spacing is the extra space before or after paragraphs. Customizing this in addition to line spacing can also make your document look more professional. To do this, select a paragraph and go back to the line spacing button and select space before paragraph option. You can click on custom spacing and add the spacing for line as well as a paragraph. And click on Apply. You can also adjust the alignment using some of the text alignment options that can be found in the toolbar. You can see left, center, right, and the justify alignment here. This will help to align a paragraph in the document as I am showing you now. When you format a particular word in a document, and if you want the same formatting to be done in other words also, that is, you want to repeat the action, then you can use the paint format function. To use this, first select the formatted word and click the paint format button in the toolbar. Next, drag in the text where you want to use the same format. It is similar to you painting over the text. This can also be achieved by simply using a Ctrl plus Y shortcut on your keyboard. Bullets. Bullets can be used in your document when you are listing anything as points. You can select the points in which you want to add bullets and click on Bulleted List options. You can see a variety of bullet options available. Select any one of them and apply to our document. You can also add numbering to your points by clicking this numbered list from the toolbar. These are all the basic formatting options. Please explore all the other features available here. Now, let's see about the indent feature. Indent defines the distance between your left or right margin and the point where your sentence starts or ends. You can adjust your indents by clicking the Format option in the toolbar and select Align and Indent option. As you can see here, you can increase or decrease the size of the indents of your document. You can also adjust the indent of your document by dragging this downward facing arrow. This arrow in the left side of your ruler indicates the left indent, and above it you can see the first line indent. Using this, you adjust the first line of the paragraph. Whereas the following lines of the paragraph will not be moved. The arrow on the right side indicates the right indent of your document. You can simply adjust the indents by clicking this arrow and dragging it. This is how you can indent your document. Next, let us discuss adding a border in your document. Click on Inserted Table and select One Cross Table. Now that the table is inserted, you can adjust the size of the margins by adjusting the margins in the rulers. You can also change the color and size of it by changing the table properties of the toolbar, as you can see here. And the text can be added within this table. If you created a border after you typed all the contents, you can then simply cut the contents and paste it inside the border to complete your process. And you saw it is an easy step to add borders in a document. Today, we had discussed most of the formatting options of the Google document, which will help your document look good and professional. Thank you.